for so long, but you show me better. A new kind of love, it's ever the one I want. I'm lifting you higher, higher. There's nothing that I'd rather do. I see your elevation, our praises. There's no one I love more than you. I never knew a love like this before. The kind of life that I cannot find on my own. I seen the world, but I have never been so sure that I want your heart. God, I just wanna be where you are.
Joining me for this wonderful Sunday morning for another virtual Kid Church. I want to remind you to make sure to go and share this video, share our high voltage page, Kids Quarantine, and invite your friends to tune in. You know, today we are finishing up our series on dinosaurs. Now, I know some of you guys are really sad about that and you wish that the series was longer, but I really hope that you've taken something away from this series that we've been doing over the last couple weeks. And more than just a few new informations that you might not have known about dinosaurs. You know, we've spent the last couple weeks talking about some amazing creatures. We started our dinosaur series with the mighty T-Rex. The T-Rex taught us that God gives us strength. And then we met the Stegosaurus, a well-defended creature who reminds us that God will defend his people. On Wednesday, we met the armored and dangerous Triceratops, who reminds us that God will fight for us. Now today we're going to look at one more legendary dinosaur, Unlike our previous three dinosaurs, this one, he didn't roam the earth. This one took the sky and soared high above. They call this one a pterodactyl. The pterodactyl roamed the skies with the huge featherless wings. Their wings were made from membrane and tissue that stretched from their ankles to an elongated fourth finger. Pterodactyls saw the world from high above. They took the skies to hunt, but I imagine they did more than just hunt. They probably enjoyed drifting through the skies on the winds. Our big idea today reminds us of pterodactyls, because this is what it says. God's love makes us soar. Can you guys say that with me this morning? God's love makes us soar. Following God won't give us the ability to fly, which would be pretty cool, but it's just not going to happen. But God's love can make our hearts soar. When we see just how much God loves us, it fills us with joy. And you know what? It makes us glad, even in times that are tough, because we know that our Creator is with us. And He makes us glad because we know that with God, we have eternal life. One of the greatest prophets in the Old Testament was a man named Elisha. Can you say that with me? Elisha. One more time. Elisha. Now, Elisha was a student of Elijah. I know, right? That can be really confusing. Elijah and Elisha. Elijah was another wonderful prophet. Elisha knew that Elijah's days were numbered and coming to an end. And while he was sad that his master was going to leave, he refused to leave his master's side. Elisha witnessed a moment that would make his heart soar and prepare him to take over Elijah's work.
Not long before the Lord took Elijah up into heaven in a strong wind, Elijah and Elisha were leaving Gilgal. Elijah said to Elisha, "The Lord wants me to go to Bethel, but you must stay here." Elisha replied, "I swear by the living Lord and by your own life that I will stay with you no matter what." And he went with Elijah to Bethel. A group of prophets who lived there asked Elisha, "Do you know that today the Lord is going to take away your master?" "Yes, I do," Elisha answered, "but don't remind me of it." Elijah then said, "Elisha, now the Lord wants me to go to Jericho, but you must stay here." Elisha replied, "I swear by the living Lord and by your own life that I will stay with you no matter what." And he went with Elijah to Jericho. A group of prophets who lived there asked Elisha, "Do you know that today the Lord is going to take away your master?" "Yes, I do," Elisha answered, "but don't remind me of it." Elijah then said to Elisha, "Now the Lord wants me to go to the Jordan River, but you must stay here." Elisha replied, "I swear by the living Lord and by your own life that I will never leave you." So the two of them walked on together. 50 prophets followed Elijah and Elisha from Jericho, then stood at a distance and watched as the two men walked towards the river. When they got there, Elijah took off his coat, then he rolled it up and struck the water. At once, a path opened up through the river, and the two of them walked across it on dry ground. After they had reached the other side, Elijah said, "Elisha, the Lord will soon take me away. What can I do for you before that happens?" Elisha answered, "Please, give me twice as much of your power as you give the other prophets, so I can be the one who takes your place as their leader." "It won't be easy," Elijah answered. "It can happen only if you see me as I am being taken away." Elijah and Elisha were walking along and talking, when suddenly there appeared between them a flaming chariot pulled by fiery horses. Right away, a strong wind took Elijah up into heaven. Elisha saw this and shouted, "Israel's cavalry and chariots have taken my master away!" After Elijah had gone, Elisha tore his clothes in sorrow. Elisha's coat had fallen off, so Elisha picked it up and walked back to the Jordan River. He struck the water with the coat and wondered, will the Lord perform miracles for me as he did for Elijah? As soon as Elisha did this, a dry path opened up through the water and he walked across. When the prophets from Jericho saw what happened, they said to each other, Elisha now has Elijah's power. They walked over to him and bowed down.
Elisha could have left Elijah's side, but he knew, just as the other prophets knew, that Elijah was about to pass away, and he refused to walk away. Elisha was sad, and he wanted to be by his master's side till the very end. And as a result, Elisha was the only one who witnessed one of the greatest miracles in the Bible. God sent a chariot down from the sky to pick up Elijah, literally, and take him back up into heaven. You see, God did more than just take Elijah away to his reward. Even though Elisha had to stay here on earth, God lifted Elisha's spirit. He filled him with the power that Elijah had as a prophet. And he knew that even though Elijah was gone, God was with him. He had great joy, and he had courage to carry on the work that his master had begun.
Hey guys, we're doing the memory verse today. Did you know, we're learning about the pterodactyl this week. Did you know that the P is silent in pterodactyl?
Now we're doing the memory verse.
Be strong and take heart, all you who hope in the Lord. Psalm 31:24.
We will pass the ball to each other and say the memory
verse. If you don't have a ball, you can just repeat after us.
Okay. Be strong and take heart.
Be strong and take heart.
All you who hope in the Lord.
All you who hope in the Lord.
Psalm 31. 24.
24.
Bye.
Bye, guys.
Sometimes we go through tragic times. We all have those times that we just want to give up. Even Elijah and Elisha did. And that's when we need to look to the sky, to remember God's love, and the goodness of God will fill our hearts with great joy. When you're having a bad day, remember all the things that God has given you. Thank God for your family and your close friends. Thank Him for the blessings that He has given you, the talents and the gifts that are unique to you. Remember that God is not done, and thank Him for all that He has done. When you lose a loved one, and that can be really hard, and it makes us really sad, but thank God that He brought that person into your life. Remember the good times that you had, and thank God for those times. Remember the lessons that you learned from that person, and never forget those. Don't forget what Elisha did when he was filled with God's Spirit after his master went to heaven. He didn't keep it for himself. He used it to share God's love with others. And Elisha did some amazing miracles with the power that God gave him. He used his gifts to show people all around him God's love. And he is remembered as a man who pointed people back to God. Let God's love make you soar like an eagle or a pterodactyl. But don't fly solo. Share the good things that God has given you. Love your family, your friends, and your enemies. Look to those who need us most, as Elisha did, and share with them what God has for them. One day, everyone who loves the Lord will be like Elijah, flying away to be with the Lord in heaven. Until then, though, let's do the work that God has called us to do. Let's love like God loves us. And let's give others a reason to let their hearts soar. Let's pray. Lord God, I thank you so much. I thank you, Lord God, that, that you have equipped every single one of us, Lord God. It doesn't matter if we're 4 years old or if we're 40 years old, God. You desire to use us. You desire to love us. You desire to change us, Lord God. And you desire for us to share that love with other people. Lord God, I pray that we will truly be filled with your spirit, Lord God. That we will soar, Lord God, and let others see your love and your joy inside of us. I thank you, Lord God, that people will notice that we are different. And that difference is you. Lord, I thank you so much. I pray, God, that you continue to use us in mighty ways. Lord God, even in this season that we're in, it may be difficult and it may look different. But Lord God, that you have a plan and a purpose for each one of us. So I pray, Lord God, may we be in tune to you, Lord God. May we hear your voice and may we move just as you have called us to move. Lord God, we love you and we thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. Don't forget what Elisha did with... Don't forget what Elisha... also remembered a man. Lord help me.
Hey guys, it's me and Jared doing the memory verse today.
Today we're going to be learning, this week we're going to be learning about the pterodactyl. Did you know that the P is silent in pterodactyl?
Now we're going to toss the ball to each other.
We're going to, no, I'm supposed to say that.